Welcome to Six Sigma Mania. Let me share with you criteria for choosing first DMAIC Green Belt projects, prior we jump into project examples. You are new in Six Sigma. I recommend to start with something easy, simple. It is like starting learning new language. You start with simple words at the beginning, and not complicated sentences, right? First criteria is choose simple project, possible to accomplish within 2 to 3 months maximum. Identify project with sponsor that will support you. Make sure that sponsor understand benefits project can deliver. Next criteria for project choosing is that you are familiar with problematic you attempt to address. Do your project with a team 3 to 4 team members. Do your project within your working group without other departments involvement. Select problem or process portion you can influence within your group. Use simple Lean Six Sigma tools like project charter, process map, Pareto analysis and so on. Try to avoid using heavy statistics. And last criteria, or better said advice from me is, make your time available for this activity. I recommend you testing project idea on project calculator, I have developed based on my training experiences. It can help you determine how demanding leading project will be for you. Link to download this tool is under the video. Example for project 1, is recommendation for production-oriented projects. And it is 5S organization in common cabinet, or work table. By having tools and equipment on the right place can save up to 30% of working time. Especially, when several people are sharing it. Try to measure, or simply estimate save time for your case. Key tool to be used is 5S method. Where you sort material in the first step. This is the most difficult. People are used to store material, tools, that are never, or very seldom used. Following steps are easier. By set in order phase, you identify place, where material that left after sorting will be placed. Shine phase is about cleaning from dust, chips, dirt and so on. In standardization, each equipment and material have special place identified. In sustaining phase you set rules to be followed during, or by the end of the shift. Project 2 is production oriented too. It is layout organization. Choose small area, like one work table, machine, or work cell, and try to improve access to required material. People can walk several miles per day to fulfill their work. That is not efficient, and it is time consuming. If you move key material close to their area, you can eliminate waste of waiting, or transportation. Great tool to be used here is spaghetti diagram. Start with understanding current status with measuring actual meters, or time spent during walking. Then develop ideal layout with your team. Compare new status with previous after implementing changes. Project 3, warehouse, / storage organization. It can be shelf, or cabinet fill optimization. You can try to reduce material volumes here. It is material, that is indirect. Like optimizing number of machining tools. Or lowering any other material volumes. This optimization will have direct impact on financial result. You can have less material on hand with process still working ideally. Key here is to define minimum and maximum required volumes per each material. And you can determine it based on historical consumptions, or predictions based on future demand. Then visualize those limits inside cabinet. It will be obvious to any supplier, or user if there is optimum material on hand. Project example number 4, planning or scheduling improvement. This project example is more for office-oriented projects. Releasing parts to production is important for the rest of the process. Try to understand how releasing could be done better. How this process is influencing others and how you could do it better, or easier. Try to identify ways slowing down your process. It can be long walk to the printer. It can be too many papers you are printing out. Is there a way to optimize it? Good tool that can help you with this is process mapping. Map current process as it works first. Then put on paper your ideal future map. And create a plan how to reach it. Project example number 5, is improvement in engineering. Engineers are responsible for many processes. Your project can be to develop flow charts for those processes. If flow charts already exists, you can review them, and do an update to be actual. Another idea can be process instructions actualization, or simplification. Choose limited number of instructions, and try to simplify it as much as possible. Tool you can use to understand what to improve is voice of customer and SIPOC. By using them, you can understand gaps in the process you're trying to improve. Last advice prior ending this video. Whatever improvement you do, even it will be 20% improvement, it is great start. Do not have extra high expectations. Even a small improvement is great and helpful. Try to learn tools by using them, and improve your processes step by step. Results will come, and will surprise you and your teammates. Take a look under the video, where you find a link to my blog, where you can download many free templates. Use it, share it. If you find this video helpful, give us a like. Have a great day.